Studio Q, Queen Student Television Program, is brought to you in part by Procter & Gamble, continuing a long tradition of hiring Queen students. And by Kingston Area McDonald's Restaurants. You can enjoy all your McDonald's favorites by calling 1-800-663-2233 for McDonald's delivery in Kingston. All you have to do is call and let McDonald's do the rest.
And I'm Teza Lawrence.
And welcome to our second last episode of Studio Q.
We're not done yet.
No. Today we bring you Studio Q from the top of the JDC.
We can see all of Kingston,
very
actually.
Very reality bites. It's our last show. We have nowhere to go.
We're graduating and we're useless.
We have no future. Yes, we do.
But this week's show is a bit of a different show. We're not going to bring you news stories. In fact, what we're going to do is run a bit of a show of highlights from the past few years on Studio Q episodes. So just relax, put your feet up, enjoy your craft dinner, and watch this look back at Studio Q.
We'll have stories on the Vanier Cup as well as the World Series Street Party. We also have an investigative report from the past, tracking Arnold Schwarzenegger in Kingston.
But first, the current strike of full-time workers for Marriott Food Services has put a bit of a wrench in our plans to run an entire episode of Repeats. And with the journal no longer publishing and the ban on CFRC, we thought we'd bring you a bit of an update on the current story.
70 full-time food service workers hit the picket lines Monday morning under the careful eye of Queen Security. At issue is job security and a pension plan for workers. They claim that they are the only full-time Queen's employees without a plan. In addition, part-time workers are demanding equal pay. The university says since Marriott holds the food services contract, it's a dispute between the union and Marriott management. The union says it's Queen's administration that ultimately pays for everything. They are responsible for the strike. Wednesday morning, the union decided to defy administration orders to stay out of public buildings or risk trespassing charges. They set up an information picket outside of the McCory cafeteria and were met by Queen Security.
So you're planning on staying then? Your position? Okay, great. Nice.
They refused to leave, citing a section of the Labor Relations Act protecting their right to picket. In the end, no charges were laid. Right now, campus cafeterias and residence foods are being run by Marriott managers and part-time staff. Students could feel the effects of the strike this weekend, though. Midnight Friday is when 175 part-time workers become eligible to walk the picket line. Marriott is bound by contract to provide food for students and residents, but the union says the only way to do that is to overwork their managers or hire replacement workers. That's illegal under new labor legislation. No one from Marriott management or the university was available for comment. For Studio Q, I'm Mike Wise reporting.
Still to come on Studio Q, hot on the trail of Arnold. Was he really in Kingston, or was it just a hoax?
Another speculation by those in the know is that maybe he is in fact scouting locations for a kindergarten cop too.
Catch a special look back at classic Studio Q from 4 years ago, later, only on Studio Q.
Well, the Blue Jays are once again off to a great start to their season, making it awfully hard to study for exams here at Queens. And over the past few years, the Blue Jays' successes have brought a lot of exciting times for Queens students. Behind me here in particular on University Ave is where one of the long-standing traditions came back over the last 2 years. The Blue Jays' back-to-back World Series brought the annual street party once again back to the Queens ghetto. And Bruce Sellery was there to catch an exclusive look at this street party.
Blue Jay fever preempted the midterm crunch last week, drawing unprecedented crowds to the big screen at Alfie's. Saturday night's game, the sixth and final of the World Series, was immortalized in the bottom of the 11th inning. It was impeccable timing that the bars closed immediately following, sending fans en masse into the streets to celebrate, especially here on University Avenue, where many gathered at a huge street party.
Coming out. two by two, four by four, eight by eight, 16 by 16, hundreds of people at a time.
Queen's University hasn't seen a street party like this since October homecoming in 1987. But the Toronto Blue Jays win of the World Series was reason enough to gather again for this legendary celebration.
But in 1987, a similar event turned ugly. Students were arrested, property damaged, and the incident attracted national media attention that effectively put an end to such revelry. This time, the kinder, gentler Queens prevailed.
Most of the crowd is fairly friendly. That's what we like to see.
Police presence helped to keep things under control. Later, they prevented more revelers from joining the party by blocking pedestrian access from all directions. But at its peak, the street party hosted upwards of 3,000 people. This with another impromptu bash on Princess Street as well.
I was big time stressed, big time. But the Jays win it, Winfield, boom!
As we now know, the Jays' win wasn't enough to carry the yes side in the referendum. But the first Canadian team to capture the World Series certainly strummed on rusty, patriotic heartstrings. Everyone exuded pride in Canada, but also in Queens. A spontaneous street party of this magnitude was a flashback to wilder times. Because for reasons just or unjust, Queens has changed dramatically in the past 3 years. Major steps taken to eliminate sexism, racism, and homophobia have tamed traditions and prompted widespread concern that the unique Queens spirit was evaporating. Concern that we'd remain a fine educational institution, but lose our position as Canada's preeminent spirit institution. Last Saturday's street party proved that the fire is alight. Queen's spirit lives on. For Studio Q, I'm Bruce Sellery reporting.
Studio Q has seen a lot of changes over the year. This was its original opening. Until last year, Studio Q was actually recorded and put together in a studio using the cable net facilities on Coburn Street every Tuesday night. Last year, the show bought an editing suite, which meant we could edit and put the show together almost right up until airtime.
Ron Tight, welcome to yet another edition of Studio Q.
It came in handy for a couple of stories, like this demonstration last year that broke only 3 hours before the show was to go on air. One of our most well-received stories last year was Kevin Bryenton's survey of wheelchair accessibility around campus. What made his approach special was that he actually spent a week using a wheelchair.
10 minutes between classes usually gives a student time to grab a bite to eat, chat with a friend, and still make it to class on time. Choosing Dunning Auditorium and the Technological Center to represent an average class change, it required a full 10 minutes simply to go from building to building in a wheelchair. Simple maneuvers like stepping over curbs and snow piles represent major stumbling blocks to a wheelchair student. Stray garbage and poorly placed garbage cans end up making speedy class changes a dream, not a reality. On the accessibility scale of 0 to 5, Studio Q gives winter accessibility on Queen's campus a 3.
On the other side of the scale, Nick Kindler's survey of the best places to buy poutine didn't win many fans.
In all honesty, this is probably... You alright?
Yeah, fine.
In all honesty, this is probably the worst poutine I've ever had.
If a reporter has a good idea for a story, they usually have the freedom to go and pursue it.
We now beam Lenore at you.
Greetings, Earthlings. It has been
that was the case with Lenore MacAdam, our resident Trekker, when she filed this report on the Queen's Star Trek Club.
Star Trek paraphernalia has become very popular, both with the original series and the next generation. And speaking of the new Star Trek, which series do people like better?
Well, personally, I like the new Star Trek better. Next Generation to me is a lot more current. The issues are more relevant.
The new.
Like the new one better?
Less stereotypes.
Oh, without a doubt, it would be the new one.
The new one?
Yeah, it's a lot fancier.
How about
yeah, the new one, definitely. New one. Yeah.
Well, I, for one, prefer the old series.
I'm Lenore MacAdam for Studio Q. Live long and prosper.
One of our most popular segments on Studio Q is Streetwise, where we take to the campus and ask students a different question each week. In the past, we had a feature that was just the opposite, called I'm Just Curious, where we take the time to answer students' curious questions about the university. Here's Liz Eustace with one installment.
Hi, I'm Liz Eustace for Studio Q, and this week I'm going to be asking fellow students what exactly they're curious about on campus. Who's that painting really of? Where does that door lead to? And what exactly does this painting behind me really mean?
Alfie's clothes, where are they?
You know,
here we are at Summerhill Mansion. As we proceed through its long halls, down further into its dark, dark basement, we just happen to fall upon Alfie's clothes. They were right here on campus all the time. Well, this obviously is a ladies' room, so the question is, what's a man doing in here? He's my camera person. However, what exactly is this? A cot? A table? This is really weird. What's it doing here?
Well, basically, it's for any student or staff member who aren't feeling well and need to lie down for a short period of time, and they can use that until later on.
I'm curious about that interlocking stone. Is it Italian?
Yes, it is Italian in origin with French influence, laid down in 1963. Here's another little mystery at Douglas Library. What exactly are these shelves for? How did the person get the books in there? Why are they there?
Graduate lockers, you know, and they're assigned to graduate students only. They can sign books out and keep the books in the lockers, you know.
They have their own key then?
They have their own keys, yes.
And one other thing. I'm sure everybody has a comfortable bed at home, but why do they come to the library just to sleep? I'm with Queen's TV, and I'm wondering if you're curious about anything on campus.
It's a joke.
One thing that I'm curious about would probably be the art sculpture outside Agnes Etherington.
Well, I hope we solve some of your mysteries here on Are You Curious this week. However, some things just remain yet to be defined. I'm Liz Eustace for Studio Q.
So, Graham, did you ever see any of the previous year's shows from Studio Q?
Studio Q? Yeah. No, in fact, I never watched the show. I must admit, before this year. No, I saw a couple episodes, actually, but only of last year. I didn't go see back for sure.
Yeah, it's really come a long way.
Really, really poor back then, eh?
Well, not poor, just in its early stages.
Well, of course, they were working with the cameras with the big poof of smoke and the little hood over the cameraman, right?
Yeah, I know.
Way back then with the candle and stuff, like
yeah,
the Flintstones.
Yeah, we really have come a long way.
Well, actually, the reason why we don't have much footage from the first couple of years of Studio Q is that our executive producers decided to take all of the tapes with them when they left Queen's University. In fact, the only tapes we have are of an off-air recording of our current executive producer that he made when he was a frosh in Vic Hall.
And although the video quality is really, really bad, we thought we'd bring you a taste of the early days of Studio Q when Jamie Farr went out on a search to find Arnold Schwarzenegger when there was rumor that he was in Kingston.
We interrupt the show momentarily for a special live report. Studio Q investigative reporter Jamie Farr is in downtown Kingston at this point at a reputable downtown location. And he has a fast-breaking story. If we could go to Jamie. Jamie, can you hear me?
Hello, Brucey. Yes, I hear you loud and clear. For those of you who may have heard the rumors or who may have run directly into the massive veil of secrecy, I can say now with almost certainty that it is true, Arnold Schwarzenegger is in Kingston. I repeat, Arnold Schwarzenegger is in Kingston. Now, we haven't had that confirmed, but several of our journalists do believe we've seen him. For several days now, I, along with our crack team of dedicated journalists, have been trying to track down this elusive superstar. In many cases, we've run into open hostility as we've tried to find this man. Definitely members of Schwarzenegger's entourage want to keep this very secret. This is a very quiet trip. This should not get out.
Jamie, it seems rather weird that Schwarzenegger is here in Kingston. It's a small place. Do you have any idea, any clue why he's here?
We're not quite sure why he is here. All I can say right now is that he has been sighted. We've seen him downtown, or we believe we've seen him downtown. We have some footage. You'll see that later. I can only speculate. Currently, what can we have an update? My producer Damon Kindler has an update. Damon, why don't you come out here and tell us what have you found out?
Okay, Jamie, the latest that we can speculate as far as why Arnold Schwarzenegger is in Kingston is that inside sources have said that he might be visiting a local celebrity, Dan Aykroyd. That is unconfirmed. Another speculation by those in the know is that maybe he is in fact scouting locations for Kindergarten Cop 2. Another possibility, this is an outside chance, is that it's a surprise speaking engagement at Grand Hall. Again, Jamie, these are all unconfirmed, and that's really all we know at the moment. We really don't know much more.
Okay, thank you very much, Damien. Thank you. Keep us updated if there's any change on that. Bruce?
Jamie, you didn't seem to expect a large number of fans who would be welcoming Schwarzenegger to Kingston. Do you have any idea why people aren't there? Is he here?
Okay, there's no one down here because I must reiterate that this matter has been kept very quiet. Nobody is to know about this. How do we know he's here? Well, actually, we're not quite sure. We haven't seen him actually come in or out of here, but there have been several indications that something fishy is going on here. As you may notice behind me, security has been increased. Security, I notice, is never this strong down here. How do we know he's here in general? I think we have some tape. We have some tape that we shot earlier today. I believe, have you got it queued? Okay. Right now, we're going to roll that tape of what we believe to be Arnold Schwarzenegger, downtown Kingston, shot earlier today. Okay, roll the tape. Now, roll it. That's Arnold Schwarzenegger. He's just come out of Cafe Max. Don't want to get too far behind him. We're gonna follow him. We're gonna try and keep out of sight. We don't want to spook him.
No, I don't see him, David.
No.
Okay.
Oh, no. How'd he go?
Cut it.
Okay, Farr, there he is, man.
Okay.
All right.
You picked up the trail. Going to the building here. We're going to try and see if we can get a word with him. We tracked him here. We think he's in this room.
Mr. Schwarzenegger
here?
No, I'm sorry, Mr. Schwarzenegger's not here.
Are you sure? I thought I saw him in there.
I'm sorry, you must be mistaken.
Really?
He's really not here.
Really? Okay.
Did you
leave
a message?
No, it's okay. Thank you very much. We'll come back later, maybe.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Well, Bruce, I mean, that footage says it all. I mean, that just sums it up. He's here. He's here somewhere. I know it. I can sense it in my bones. I've got to really give my hand to the guys, the camera guys, taking that footage. That was excellent. We appear to be having some technical difficulties with our lights, but that doesn't matter. We have enough natural light here. It should suffice. Not much more to report at this point. I'd just like to say that I, along with my cameraman, Dave Brady, Damon Kindler, the producer, will stick it out here. We're going to stay here till something happens. I'm sure this will be soon, and we will keep you updated. Once again, Arnold Schwarzenegger in Kingston, probably here. We're not quite sure. It's not confirmed. This is Jamie Farr live in Kingston. Back to you, Bruce.
Thank you, Jamie. Wow, this is really exciting. What I'm wondering is what Arnold Schwarzenegger is doing walking into my astonishing self, the lingerie store. Okay, now I think it's time for a rare treat. Bruce, you have a story for us this week, don't you? And now for my favorite part of the show, the upcoming events around town. Beginning of the week, we have the...
Excuse me, Brian, can I interrupt for just 1 second? Okay, we have another update from Jamie Farr. He's standing by downtown once again. I think there's some news there. Jamie, can you hear me? Do we have Jamie online?
I want you to leave. Jamie?
Bruce, the climate is starting to heat up here. Unfortunately, security is getting a little angry. They've asked us to leave. The climate's not good right now. I'm going to try.
Can you please get out of here?
All I want to know, is Arnold Schwarzenegger here? Is Arnold Schwarzenegger here?
No, we don't. We can't answer your questions, I'm sure. Listen, get out of here now.
Get that camera off now. Get it off.
Guys,
get it off now.
Hey, leave him alone. Leave him alone. What is the problem here?
You understand?
What is causing you trouble?
What is the problem?
Hey, you can't do that. You can't do that. You can't do that. You are from Studio Q. Leave us alone. Leave us alone. Hey.
We seem to have lost touch with Jamie. I hope he's okay and can contact us again immediately as soon as he can. Wow. You know, Bruce, I just realized that Total Recall is playing this Thursday at the Student Film Theater. Coincidence? I think not. Our Streetwise segment is important because it gives you, the student, a forum for expressing your opinions or feelings on very important topics. With this in mind, Studio Q reporter Jen Mondoux hit the streets to get your feelings on life's most pressing questions, such as, what is a throng? Here are some of your answers.
Queen's University, an institution known for its superior academics and rated as one of the best universities in the country.
A school with such a strong reputation would be sure to find students with wide ranges of knowledge. What better way to test that knowledge than to take your standard dictionary and ask the average Queen's student on the street the meaning of a fairly simple word, namely, what is a throng?
The search for the correct definition began at Douglas Library, a place rumored to be full of smart people. So what is a throng anyway?
Throng, as in a large group of people who come together for something other than politically correct motives.
I don't know. I don't know, to throw.
The search then moved to University Avenue, where we found several clued out people, at least as far as the meaning of throng goes.
Throng.
Throng, I'm speechless. I'm just speechless. Jump up and down.
Throng.
Throng. Isn't that like a sound effect? Isn't that like a sound effect for something?
It's when you missay thong, and you actually put an R in there instead. So you get throng.
They're for tying people up with, throngs.
Oh, okay.
Throngs, yeah.
Okay.
Throngs.
No idea. Is it that little piece of leather that goes between your big toe on a sandal?
No.
I'm stumped.
Isn't that those weird kind of dresses that those ladies wear? Like the throng?
It's a throng.
Oh, it's throng. I thought that was a throng. Sorry.
I have no opinion.
I'm Jen Mondoux, reporting for Studio Q.
Well, behind me we can see Stouffer Library is coming along quite nicely, and it should be ready for the beginning of next year, hopefully. But firstly, what's the biggest sports highlight in the history of Studio Q? Without a doubt, it has to be the 1992 Vanier Cup victory. And why is that? Because we moved our entire show to the Sky Dome to bring you live coverage from the sidelines of the game.
Yes. I am Kirsten Teague.
And I'm Ron Tight. We are on location at the Sky Dome. Plenty of excitement here.
We just won Vanier Cup 31-0.
31-0. The place was crazy. After the gales, it was nuts, wasn't it?
Crazy.
Just crazy. All right, how about we go back and take a look at some of the highlights?
Pirates was a perfect day for a game of the old pigskin. Eastern style, lots of rain and gray sunshine. The best of the nation gathered inside the big igloo in T.O. And as the lads from St. Mary's Way came to town, they was led by one big Bonavista Bay boy. All Canadian defenseman, Alex Aliopoulos,
St. Mary's entered Vanier as overwhelming favorites due to their extremely stingy defense. Giving up less than 9 points per game all season made the odds against the Gales almost believable. Almost. The Vanier matchup, however, focused down on two players, and this time it was personal. The fleet of foot Gaelic warrior Brad Elbert and the Huskies' most effective stopper, Mr. Aliopoulos himself, battled to deadlocks many times early on in the game. And although it looked like a Husky advantage was ready to unfold, it was Elberg, as he danced the wee jig around those dumbfounded Duggies from St. Mary's and romped into their end zone three separate times. St. Mary's just couldn't seem to put anything together to break the big goose egg on the board, though.
Too much cod liver oil on their gloves, I'd say.
And the tumbling of all pregame predictions gave Queens fans further reason to cheer, as its lead went up by leaps and bounds. The end of the first half stopped play momentarily and allowed Studio Q to accost itself some celebrity predictions about the remainder of the game. We had the ultra-conservative prediction. We had the totally clueless prediction.
How you doing? I'm just out here enjoying the game. I don't know who to root for because this is my first college game in Canada, so I guess I'm rooting for Queens because they're winning and the fans behind me, so I got to cheer for them.
Thank you very much, Derek. Maybe you better spend a little less time on the bench and a little more time on the trail of university football. All predictions were nonetheless offered in the shadow of inevitable victory. And as the Knight emerged victorious from the game-long offensive and defensive joust, he was wearing red, yellow, blue, and the number one. And after all the hard hits were delivered and the field gun went off, the battle-weary opponents conceded a small mark of kinship in a pastime bigger than both of them. They had now only to look forward to bright futures and restful weekends. So it's all over, right? Well, not quite yet. What about our other unique Kingston tradition?
Are you going to be laying the kibosh on anybody who tries to get down there or what?
Negative. My main concern is to make sure that the poles don't get ripped off.
Yeah, right. The field rush was indeed successful. But before we could celebrate at ground level en masse, a few brave fans had to make a run for the border. And boy, did it suck to be them. If not for the effort of these few, however, and the Gales football team, none of this Arcana would be possible at all.
Well, as the lights are going down in the Sky Dome, all I can say is 1992, what a year. Canada turns 125 years old. We win the World Series of the Gales. Take the Vanier! All right! All the hard work paid off, guys. Way to go. For Studio Q, this is Kevin Bryenton reporting.
That's it for this week's show. Thank you very much for watching.
And as we say goodbye from the roof of the J-Dock, we don't have a giveaway this week, which is quite unfortunate. But if you want, and I know everybody does, you can still call us or write us or send us postcards.
Got a little extra time in your hands.
Little extra time.
We'd love to chat.
We'd love to chat. So our number, once again, is 545-6699. Or yes, yes, I know you're asking that. You can write us. Our address is Studio Q, Room 22, John Deutsch University Center, Kingston, Ontario, K7L3N6.
So be sure to tune in next week when we have our final finale.
Yes, we have one more week.
That's it, we promise.
We're still coming
and
at you.
And we'll have some really good bloopers and, once again, a look at some past stories, etc.
So for this week, that is it. For Studio Q, I'm Gary Mabby.
And I'm Teza Lawrence.
We'll see you next week.
Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I want to run,
I want to hide, I want to tear down the walls from the inside. I want to reach out, touch the flame, where the streets have no name. Oh yeah.
Studio Q is brought to you in part by Procter & Gamble, proudly employing Queen students for the past 30 years.
and the Kingston area McDonald's, featuring home delivery service. Just phone 1-800-663-2233 for all your favorites.